Team Tarani comprised of 6 Indian naval women officers who came from different cadres and took on the expedition of Navika Sagar Parikrama. Lieutenant Commander Vartika Joshi was the skipper of this team. She takes her own time to come to a decision, but when she does, it becomes a team's decision. She's a very good leader. Lieutenant Commander Pratibha Jamwal is a Josh box, and she was like the second in command. Lieutenant Commander Aishwarya Bodapati, she is one person who kept the team together. Lieutenant Commander Swati Patrapalli was one person the team would have never been able to sail with. Lieutenant Commander Vijaya, very, very strong person mentally, who would stand by you if everything fell apart. Lieutenant Payal would always be a second to anyone who is attempting anything. As a team, they could achieve something that no one has ever achieved before.
This idea of circumnavigation in India was conceptualized by Vice Admiral Manohar Rawati. Any circumnavigation voyage includes several criteria. We need to start and finish at the same port. So we started our voyage from Goa, and after circumnavigating the planet, we came back to Goa. We were going to be the first military organization in the world to be attempting such a thing. We started this voyage on 10th of September 2017. And the voyage encompassed 4 planned stopovers, and there was a 5th emergency layover that we had to make in Mauritius.
The leg one consists of moving the distance of around 5400 nautical miles, and then we went from India, started from Goa to the Fremantle, which is in Australia,
which took us 42 days to cover. This was the first leg, and this was the first time we were heading eastwards. Whereas in all the 2.5 years of training, we had gone on voyages westwards on the planet.
Every leg had its own challenges because of the kind of weather that we faced. So first leg was from here to Australia, in which we ran out of water.
Our RO plant gave up, and there was no water supplies which we were having. So whatever water we had, we did rainwater harvesting.
This leg taught us to, you know, appreciate the resources that we have and make use, be resourceful and make use of those resources.
From Australia, we started for Littleton, and we took almost about 25 days to cross that patch. And we were kind of lucky enough that winds were supportive, and we were getting good downwind thrust, and then we were moving with good speed. Once we reached Littleton, it was almost like half of the journey is completed.
And the next leg was going to be the longest leg of the voyage, the leg 3, from New Zealand to the Falkland Islands through the South Pacific.
The most dangerous leg that we had, we crossed the entire South Pacific Ocean. We faced a lot of storms, and one was the major storm. It was hurricane force. The winds were at 150 kilometers per hour, and the sea was as high as 9 to 10 meters. So to put it in prospect, 9 to 10 meters is a 3-storied building.
It was the most difficult one, but it also gave us the confidence that yes, we can do it.
In those 19-20 hours, with sub-zero temperatures and hailstorms coming in every couple of hours, we had to keep the boat safe. And in those times, we realized how important it was to be with each other. So after 25 days, we crossed the Atlantic Ocean, and we reached in Cape Town on the day of Holi. This was sort of, a celebratory leg, because the last leg was our final leap back towards home.
Swati ma'am, what are you up to? Here.
While coming back home, we all were really excited that yes, we are going back, we're going to meet our parents after so long, after like 254 days.
Everybody back home was waiting for us. There were a lot of preparations going on to receive us.
We were few thousand miles from India, we encountered a major emergency en route. Close to Mauritius, our steering gear gave up. We were stranded in the middle of the ocean for almost 12 hours.
Imagine a car without a steering.
After temporary repairs of the steering system, we managed to steer the boat slowly and steadily towards the nearest port, which was Mauritius. So there we carried out our necessary repairs and headed back home. On 21st of May 2018, we arrived back in our home port here in INS Mandovi.
Any father would feel very proud of their own children. I think the Navy, being the father, feels extremely proud of what these six women naval officers have accomplished. They have etched their names in history.